Hi, in this video, we're going to talk about target group for English teacher. The thing is, while I'm traveling around, I see a lot of things. I also see how teachers are getting the clients. I also see how English houses like organization are getting the clients. And in this video, I'm going to talk about it. I'm going to give you a clear view so you know, okay, if I'm focused on this specific target, what do I need to do? So let's begin. If you're an English teacher and you want to acquire more clients, then it's important to know who's going to be your students. Most of the time when you're looking for students, you do not know who the target group is. If you do not know who the target group is, then it's hard to see where you can get it. If you look at some organizations, sometimes you have schools, sometimes you have organizations that help people to learn English. So if you're an English teacher, you need to know who your target group are. If you're focused on school, if you want to teach schools, then you do that. If you want to teach at the university, you do that in the university. You can always be an employer. But if you're a freelancer and you want to get people to come to your class, or if you want people to come to your courses, or if you want to give private lesson, then it's important to know where your target group is going to be. I stayed at a couple of organizations. I saw how they work, and it comes down to mainly two things. If you're looking for students, you have students from the university or your workers. That's simple. The question is, how do you target them? How do you approach them? And that's the main question. Most of the time, most of the organizations that I saw are working just with the Facebook page and doing advertising. And based on that, they get clients. It's that simple. The advertising, how they advertise, it depends what you're offering them. But the thing is, if you use Facebook advertising, you can get some clients. Another thing is, some of them are using Google Ads. Not all of them know about it, but when you use Google Ads, you can target certain kind of people that are searching for, like, I'm learning English, those terms, those keywords, and you can target them. It's that simple, but that's digital. If you look at offline, most of the time, the organization gets a referral. So most people say, hey, I started learning English at that organization, and based on that, they come to the organization. But now we're gonna come to the sweet spot. The thing is, you can advertise or do a lot of things which you want, but it doesn't really matter. You can get some clients, but sometimes it's not enough as a private tutor. What you need to do is go to in the Facebook groups. In the Facebook group, you see people that are looking to learn English, or go to the cafes and talk to those people. If you talk to people and you have something to offer them, you can sell them. If you can sell your services, you can sell them. It's that simple. As you remember, if you have a business, you need to sell. If you do not sell, the business is not running. It's that simple. So, if you see it like this, you have a lot of choices if you're looking for a tutor. Question is, which choice is working for you? If I were an English teacher and I want to acquire students, then it's really simple. I just look why they want to learn English and how they want to learn English. In another video, I will talk about this, but just remember, if you're looking for workers, look at the right place. If you're looking for students, look at the right place. Remember, students doesn't have money. Workers have money, but they don't have time. You need to figure out how you're gonna deal with that. So I give you a clear view of what the target group can be for you, and also the problem that you're having. For example, if you have a worker doesn't have time, students doesn't have money, have a lot of time. So you need to think about how you're gonna deal with that. Sometimes you cannot charge your main price, sometimes you cannot charge too cheap, so you don't want to be too cheap. But just remember, if you offer your services, try to figure out what works best for you. And if you have a student, ask them why they want to learn English, how they are doing it now, and does it work? If you ask those questions, you know how you can approach your clients and you know how you can sell your services. I just told you a couple of problems that English teachers are having when approaching students, and some organizations still has that problem. But the thing is, it's about you. What are you going to do about it? So this is it. See you in the next video.
Infinite power.